morning church. December, last month of the year. The topic today is Go Build Your Altar. This portion is taken from Joshua chapter 4, verses 20 to 24. Now those took 12 stones and out of the river Jordan to build an altar, Joshua set up at Gilgal. And he said to the people of Israel, when your children ask their fathers in times to come, what do these stones mean? You will remind, this is a reminder of Israel that passed over a dry bed of the river as they crossed the Jordan and they're going into the promised land. And this is the Red Sea experience and all that transpired between those 40 years that they walked. They're entering the promised land, and this is being built for so that all the people of the earth may know that the hand of the Lord is mighty and that you may fear the Lord your God forever. This is a reminder of who God is and how He's led it. This is the truth. This is the truth that they've experienced, and they've felt God in their midst. Building altars of faithfulness, remembering God's goodness. As we step into the last month of the year, I would like to remember God's goodness in the months that have gone by. And as this year began with a lot of hope and promise, God has been faithful to lead us through and bring us till this and the coming time as we secure our lives into His hands. And this is only because of the corporate prayers that we come together as a body on the 31st, and we come together and with a new hope and a new promise, we walk out knowing that God is in control. For He says, be still and know that I am God. This 2020 we've experienced, we've seen God's mighty hand where everything came to a lockdown, and we as believers opened the world and we could see the promises. We knew the truth, the coming of our Lord and Savior in the hope and promise we depend on. And God in His wisdom knows, therefore He always asks us to set up reminders as He did in those days of old, so that man could remember not the works alone, but the goodness and faithfulness of God. These practices were to be kept for those times when those dark clouds begin to appear in our minds, in those situations, in those circumstances. That is when you go back to the altar and find comfort and faithfulness and the goodness of God. I seek out altars of others, and I myself set up my own through scriptures, through verses, through photographs, whatever triggers the memory of what He has done in my life. One of my favorite is Joshua 1:9. As I was about to give up before entering the Bible college, you know, I was just about to give up when I was walking through a certain place in Vasai East, and I read on a school wall this verse which said, have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous, do not be frightened and do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. And that promise has remained with me. I don't always have the same sense of closeness, the fountain of bubbling emotion, as I felt the first time I realized the depth of God's love. But I can always remember that it is true. It has stood true with the test of time. What reminds you of God's love? What is it that reminds you? Is it a photograph or a moment from a trip? Perhaps it would be as simple as a sunrise or something very sundry to others but impacting to you. Set reminders, visible reminders, and thank God for the work in your life. Write His goodness on the wall, on the walls around you, on your heart. Do not let memories slip away. When times are hard, we need to know what is true. Setting reminders of God, of His goodness, of His faithfulness, keeps our eyes fixed on what is real. Most of all, remember, altars are not supposed to be experienced alone. Spread His works across generations in your reach and seek out an opportunity to share. Your goodness of God can be shared and change others' lives. It could place a brick of faith in their life where they could stand on it and step up to faith. What we need to remember today, tomorrow, and for always is what God has done in our lives. And apparently, it's important to have times where I see all God is doing and has done in my own life. And as we begin this last month of the year, I pray you would go back in reminiscing and take out time and know these times when God has intervened and given you that Red Sea experience. Amen.